Welcome to the toolboxshop.com in the UK technical vlog. We'll be demonstrating today some heavy duty terminals. We're quickly walking through light duty terminal crimping because that's basically straightforward, and moving on to heavy duty crimping, and we'll try and speed it up a little bit so it's not as bad as it was last time, all drawn out. This one's a straightforward one, so we'll start with the products we're going to be using. The light duty terminal crimper, that's the Draper one. Many of you are familiar with it, and it's the type that you affect the crimp with the force of your hand, and the force of your hand, if you like, dictates where the crimp is set. The later version, the ratchet crimping tool, is becoming popular purely because it's preset where the crimp terminal should be set, if you like. So that instead of you relying on your own brute force, you're getting a preset, so you ratchet crimp them up. And popular with the engineers because the actual feeling out there is, you know, the one day when you affected the crimp and you had to test the crimp and the cables to see if you'd actually got it to adhere, with the ratchet you don't have that problem. Each and every time you get a crimp, and engineers still in the habit of testing the cables, which is all good practice, but they're starting to actually walk away happy that first shot does it properly. With the ratchet crimping tools, we have the Draper and the Durite range. That one there is the Draper coloured crimp terminal tool. The Durite range also has that one, but it also has the dedicated super seal, a connoisseur seal, junior power timer, and junior timer ones. Now, again, if you're going to be using the ratchet crimping tool, it's become very popular against people that are using the tools each and every day, you know, as a first line for affecting the crimps. But the light duty ones, fairly explanatory, and I'm sure many people have used them. So we're going to sideline them a bit, move them on. Again, they are available to view on the shop, but again, we're no point in demonstrating because we all know how to affect a light duty crimp. The heavy duty crimp terminals. Heavy duty crimping. Now we're going to be demonstrating the heavy duty crimps on 50mm squared cable. So just to give you an example of you know, good practice to use on heavy duty cables. Bear in mind, the heavier duty it is, the more secure it needs to be. So walking away from a job, especially after 40 miles, it's nice to know you've got peace of mind using the right equipment. Now there's two versions of the heavy duty crimps I'm going to be showing you. The first one is the old engineer's favourite, which is the Durite 0-703-80 or -80, right? Which goes from 10mm squared to 120mm squared, and it's basically designed for heavy duty crimping, anything that past 10mm. It is staged off in increments from 10mm, 16mm, 25mm, 35, 50, 70, 95, and 120. Common practice is to get the crimper set to, say, in this case we're going to be using the 50mm, and then bring it down a millimeter. I know it sounds daft, but people like peace of mind, and that millimeter seems to give a lot of people peace of mind, right? Now, it is an expensive crimper. It is, for the mobile engineer, the first choice to go on the van. But in the last couple of years, this particular one has come out. Durite has released it. It's a good little crimper. And benefits? You won't think there'll be many benefits because it's a lot cheaper as a crimper. But it does have a benefit, small and portable. With the large ones, unless you have it bench or vice mounted, you're left in a situation where you've got your terminal, you've got your cable, it will adhere, if you like, or will hold with using these, but then your cable goes in and it can move. It can move around, it can do also. So you end up using a third arm, which is your armpit, 9 times out of 10, if you're using it loose and not having it back, vice mounted. So in effect, you're holding the terminal, I'll show you this in a minute, you're holding the terminal, you're holding the cable, the only thing you've got left is your armpit. So it's good, but it does have its drawbacks. This particular one, and it's a Durite, let's have a look, 0-703-90. It is for terminals up to 95mm, and the principle behind it is we have this terminal, so place the terminal into the crimper, it's sprung loaded, so the actual terminal is held tightly in place. That allows us to hold the cable in and then strike with a hammer. Notice I've got two hands. Very ideal. Instead of holding the terminal and the cable, I'm holding the cable and I'm striking with a hammer. Downside is you've got to get used to the pressure of the hammer and everything else. But once you start using it, and once you get the feel for how hard a strike, and you can strike it twice, that's not a problem. You will get used to it, and it will become quite a good favourite. It's a budget one, but I'm not going to demonstrate that particular one for the cables, because we'll do it by the book, and as a mobile engineer, we'll do it out on the field. So I've got my crimper, I've got my terminal, I've got 50mm cable. Actually, you probably don't want to watch this bit, and I might cut it out, but let's just burn off the cable again. So I'll give a knife. Again, with light duty cable, you can get cable strippers, that's fine, it does the job. On the heavy duty cable, sometimes a Stanley knife comes into its own. And what I'm doing is to bear off the end of the cable, I've marked it off with the size of the cable, the size of the terminal, should I say. So I've marked it off to the correct depth, and then I'm going to cut all the way around with a Stanley knife. And then one cut straight down the centre, frees up and clears it off. So you notice I'm using the 50mm squared cable again. Flexible, very flexible. Benefits, well, when you're working your way around the panel, you know, when you're using the stiff sheathed type, if you like, it is a pain. So when you've got flexibility in a cable, you may think I'm shallow being excited about a cable, but when you've got flexibility in a cable, it really does help when you're trying to navigate a panel. So like we said, we get this heavy duty crimper, and now you can see what I was talking about when we're actually needing a third hand. So I have my terminal, I have my increment set to just under the 50mm mark, I grab the terminal, and then I'll start the crimp under my shoulder and then push down. So now you can see that's why it's usually bench or vice mounted. So one crimp and we've got a crimp terminal. Now you could walk away and leave it with a crimp if it's a good crimp, but on heavy duty cable, common practice and good practice is to crimp and solder. The reason being is walking away from the job, hold a second. Walking away from the job that you've just done, peace of mind is worth a fortune. So we do it for peace of mind, making sure we've got a good adhesion. And if we're going to solder it on the crimp terminals, you notice on the end of the crimp terminal, you have an eye. So basically, as you heat it up, and I'll demonstrate this probably with another terminal, when you heat it up and it's at the right heat, your tin will start to run. And when it's running, that's an indication that your terminal's hot enough to apply your solder to. By soldering and crimping, you basically, I think I might have said this before, belts and braces. Right, you're doing one and the other, so you've got two layers of protection, two layers of crimp, if you like, or two layers of adhesion onto your copper cable. There's not many people go back to a job once they've crimped and soldered, and that's the truth. So we have a slight duty. Butane, I did say I'd demonstrate it with this. It is fairly new, so I'll find my way around it. So we have as flame, we have as solder, which is T153, which is flux solder. Ideal for heavy duty crimping and terminals, right? So first off, we start to heat the terminal. Now you notice the terminal is not into the blue of the flame. If you put the terminal into the blue of the flame, you probably won't see the tin running, which is the indication that you're ready to start soldering. What you will do, we'll see, is start seeing scorching, and it makes a right mess of it. So heating the terminal up. So the terminal is hot enough, and we apply the solder into the end. You can feel it and see it running through. That's the flux, that's burning off. So the terminal into the end, and then we let it set. We know that we've got solder into the joint because the joint has filled up, and we've got remnants of it coming out, showing in the bottom. So we're fairly secure that we've got a good crimp and solder. So we're fairly secure that we've got a good solder. So let it cool down a little bit, and online, best doing it using the search, but you will find in the automotive cable section, and that is Heatshrink, red and black. So again, if you are going to be using the heavy duty 50mm square cable, you notice it's orange. So when you're using it and putting it onto panels, a black and red Heatshrink sleeve will benefit for identifying it for your positive and negative cable. So we just, 1 second. So again, heat again, locking it on, and what I'm going to do is not direct flame, just the heat from the flame. If you do, you'll scorch it and you'll make a right mess of it. So basically, just using the heat from the flame, not using the direct blue flame, we secure the heat shrink onto the cable. We sometimes talk about aesthetics of the job. It looks like the job's done properly. It's hiding up any flying loose copper cable. It's helping the integrity of the cable and the join, only slightly, but everything adds to the overall effect. So that's his cable. That's the equipment. And that's his join. So, from an engineer perspective, again, going back through the equipment, this crimping tool, which is the 0-703-80, is a first line of defence. If you're on a budget, or sometimes personal preference, the 0-703-90 comes with full recommendation. You know, it's very rarely you'll find a salesman or a salesperson actually leading you in the direction of a cheaper item. What we're saying is, yes, that would be ideal for your van. What we're also saying is, on a budget, yes, that is ideal to affect a good crimp. So that was the toolboxshop.com tech vlog for the crimping tools. It was shorter, but hopefully that'll be the format from now on. And if you want to catch up with more of the technical vlogs, please call and subscribe to the YouTube channel, and we'll keep you posted and up to date when a new video is released. Thank you and take care.